Hello. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox One. And this is my alien planet save in survival. And this is my drill rig. And this is what I've been drilling. Now, yesterday I did a tutorial on sensors and someone asked the question if I could do a tutorial on how to make an automated drilling rig. And since that was a good idea, welcome to the very short tutorial on how to make an automated drilling rig. You're going to need a few things. You're going to need to build your drill rig. And what we're looking at here is a piston. This piston is called Stone Down. I always like to name things so I know what I'm looking at when I start putting things onto control panels or starting to activate actions with timer blocks or sensors or whatever. And this is the one that we're concerned with. And what we're concerned with is making sure that share inertia tensor is enabled on all our pistons and rotors in this system. We're also making sure that the velocity is correct and the maximum distance on this piston is zero. So when you have a velocity of 0.5 meters and a maximum distance of zero, the piston is not going to move, and that's what we want, because what we want to use is a sensor to detect the subgrid, which is this thing here that's attached to my pistons and so on. Every time this subgrid here comes round one revolution or so, we want to tell it to go down. So how do we do that? Well, first of all, we need a sensor. Now, if you've got progression enabled, you're going to have to build a light first. But for the purposes of this, we want a sensor. Remember the tutorial yesterday? Sensors have the small bar at the bottom. We're going to weld our little sensor up. Remember to take tools out of your hand, hold the left bumper, press B. Then, all you want to do is look at the blue panel and press X. We don't need to rename the sensor unless we've got a lot of sensors. And what we want is we want to turn down the left extent, turn down the right extent, but we want to push the bottom extent up to about 20, 25, depending on how many pistons you've got, of course. But 20 should do. We can take the top down to reduce the power usage, probably about 2 meters, 2.5. We don't want the back extent. We'll leave the front as it is. And what we don't want is the sensor to detect players. Now, if you look between the top extent and the back extent at the sensor bar itself, it's cyan or blue. If I turn detect players off, it'll go green. That's what we want. So we go down on the D-pad until we get to subgrids. We want to turn that on. And that, we leave everything else as it is. Sensor will now react with a subgrid. What we want, though, is we want the sensor to do something. So we want to go into setup actions. And we want to look through our list. And I'm looking for piston stone down. Press A on it. Come down until we find, because we're pointing down, we need to increase the maximum distance. Remember, I set it to zero. Energy low. Just let me recharge my suit's energy. There we go. So now, when this subgrid comes round a revolution, I have set for 1 RPM, so it's 1 revolution every minute. Turn on my drills, you'll notice there's no shake because I have share inertia tensor on. and we're going to start the rotors. Now, I've covered how to put things onto control panels, how to group objects, and how to use, there we go, down it goes, button panels and things like that in previous tutorials, and they're labelled. If you want to know how to group objects, put them on button panels, that's tutorial one. Go all the way back, watch that, then you can do things like putting rotors and pistons and all sorts of lovely things onto the control panels. If we wait about a minute or so, you'll see. As it spins round, it should lower again. I always suggest putting your rotor with drills like this on about half an RPM or one RPM. You don't really want to drill too fast, and you certainly don't want to tempt clang by going too fast round and round and round, otherwise things can and will break. There you go, down it goes again. And that's really it. So there you go, that is your sensor tutorial on how to make an automated drill rig. Once again, stay safe, take care, have fun, happy engineering. Until the next one, bye for now.